Okay, what is up there, YouTube? This is J-Man Time, and today I have a video on the top 5 deadliest and most dangerous Iranian torpedo boats and missile boats that are currently in service with the Iranian Revolutionary Guards Corps Navy, or the IRGCN. Iran actually has 2 navies. You have the Iranian Navy, and then you have the Islamic Revolutionary Guards Corps Navy. Now, I already covered the Iranian warships a couple of years ago, but I haven't covered the deadliest vessels of the IRGC. Since the 1980s, the US and Iran and America's allies, mostly Saudi Arabia, Bahrain, Oman, Qatar, Britain, and South Korea, have been beefing over who will control the Strait of Hormuz, the Persian Gulf, and the Gulf of Oman. This entire region is where most of the world's oil supplies are transported through, along with the Egyptian Suez Canal. Over the last 20 to 30 years, Iran has been developing its own class of advanced missile boats and torpedo boats for both the Iranian Navy and the Revolutionary Guards Corps Navy. So in this video, we're going to go over the most dangerous and most advanced combat missile boats and torpedo boats of the Iranian Revolutionary Guards Corps that could give the U.S. Navy a run for its money in case of an all-out war between the U.S., Iran, and the U.S. and Iranian allies, mostly the EU, the Gulf Arab countries, and maybe even Russia to an extent. And the first class of vessel on the list is the Iranian Gaji and Kajami class of semi-submersible torpedo boats that were developed between 2002 and 2004. Now, the Gaji and Kajami class are actually copies of the North Korean Taedong B and C class of a torpedo boat speedboat, or torpedo speedboats that have the ability to dive at least 5 to 10 feet underwater during an attack. The first type, the Gaji type, is based on the North Korean Taedong C type. This is a 7-ton light semi-submersible torpedo boat that was developed in the late 1990s during the era of Kim Il-sung. The vessel weighs just 10 tons and has a main armament of 2 324mm torpedo tubes that can be used to launch homing torpedoes. Simple homing torpedoes that are actually copies of both the North Korean and Chinese type 324mm torpedo known in Iran as the Quds and Yazi light torpedoes. The vessel has a speed of just 50 knots or 93 kilometers per hour or 57 miles per hour and has a crew of just 2 to 3. In 2002, Iran received at least 1 or 2 copies of the North Korean Taedong C-type semi-submersible torpedo boats and began manufacturing them as the Gaji. Later on, in the same year of 2002 and in early 2003, Iran unveiled a larger version of the Gaji known as the Kajami class. The Kajami class is an enlarged Gaji class weighing about 30 tons and having the same armament of 2 324mm light torpedo tubes. Now, what makes the Kajami class a dangerous vessel is that it could fire the newer class of Iranian homing torpedoes and supercapitation torpedoes. Of the Zafar 550mm homing torpedoes, which are a new class of Iranian torpedo, or it could fire the deadlier Hoot or Whale supercapitation rocket-powered torpedo, which is a copy of the Russian VA-111 Squall torpedo. Now, the Squall, also known in Iran as the Hoot, has a maximum speed of over 220 knots, or about 230 miles per hour. It is the fastest torpedo to be used by the Iranian Revolutionary Guards Corps and by the Iranian Navy. Now, the Kajami could be fitted with torpedo tubes that could launch these high-speed torpedoes, but so far, we haven't seen the Iranians doing this. But back in 2015 and again in 2017, Iran did experiment with launching these Hoot torpedoes from missile boats. And if they can launch them from the missile boats, then they could theoretically launch them from the Kajami class of a semi-submersible torpedo boat. So that is what makes the Gaji and Kajami class some of the more dangerous torpedo boats to be used by the Iranian Revolutionary Guardscraft Naval Detachment. Now, luckily for the US, only 6 vessels have been constructed, 3 Gaji and 3 Kajami class vessels. And these vessels have been showcased over the last decade and even appeared as late as 2021. In February 2021, Iran unveiled that they were still manufacturing at least the Kajami variant of the semi-submersible torpedo boats. So these vessels are still being manufactured, and the true number of these vessels is unknown, but only 6 vessels are currently registered with the Iranian Revolutionary Guardscraft Navy. And that brings us to the next class of a deadly torpedo boat slash missile boat, and that is the Paykaap class. Now the Paykaap itself is a series of 4 variations of the same vessel, and they go under various names. The Paykaap series is based on the North Korean IPS-16 and IPS-18 series of fast attack torpedo and missile boats that were developed by the North Koreans in the year 2000-2001. Now, North Korea sent some of these vessels to Iran, and Iran has been manufacturing them themselves as the Paykaap series, and also as a spinoff version known as the TIR, or T-I-R series, fast attack missile and torpedo craft. Now the basic Paykaap, or the Paykaap 1, has a displacement of 13.7 tons. The main armament is either 2-4 Nasser 1 or Zafar 1 fire and forget anti-ship cruise missiles. Now these are copies of the Chinese C-802 anti-ship missiles that were also sold to Iran in the early 2000s, and Iran has been manufacturing them as the Nasser 1, the Kowsar, and the Zafar anti-ship cruise missiles. The vessels could also be fitted with 2 324mm homing torpedo tubes in place of the missile launchers. So this vessel here can be fitted with either missiles or torpedo tubes. The speed of the vessel is 52 knots or 96 kilometers per hour or 59.6 miles per hour, and the vessel has a maximum range of 3,000 nautical miles at 50 knots. The vessels have a crew of 3, and at least 40 of these vessels have been constructed since 2007. Now keep in mind, there are 4 variations of the Paykaap. You have the Paykaap 1, which is largely a torpedo boat, the Paykaap 2, which is a missile boat, mostly a missile boat, and then you have the Paykaap 3 and the Tier 1, which are pretty much the same vessel but fitted with different missile launchers. The Paykaap 3 is fitted with the Nasser 1, and the Tier 1 is fitted with a newer version of the Nasser missile known as the Zafar. But they are all pretty much the same hull design with different missile and torpedo launchers, and they're all part of the Paykaap class of fast attack torpedo and missile boats that were developed between 2002 and 2007 and are still in production today. Now, as of 2021, Iran is still manufacturing some of these vessels. In February 2021, Iran unveiled at least 17 more Paykaap vessels that were recently completed at the end of 2020. So Iran currently has a 40 Paykaap class of fast attack torpedo and missile boats currently in service with the Iranian Revolutionary Guardscraft Navy, and they have at least a good 20 to 30 more of these vessels in storage. You know, these are in storage shelters based in various Iranian ports throughout the coastal areas of Iran. So this is probably the most mass-produced missile boat that is currently serving in the Iranian Revolutionary Guardscraft Naval Detachment, but also in the regular Iranian Navy. Iran has also exported these vessels to Syria, and Syria has between 12 and 18 of the Paykaap class within the Syrian Navy, and these are fitted with more modern Russian anti-ship missiles instead of the Iranian missiles. So this vessel is the most mass-produced of the Iranian missile and torpedo boats, and it's probably one of the more dangerous ones because it can be fitted with so many different types of cruise missiles, light and medium cruise missiles. There's also some sources that state that this vessel can be fitted with anti-aircraft missiles, but I haven't seen this yet, and Iran has only begun testing anti-aircraft missiles on their missile boats in 2019, so maybe in the future, but not now. And that brings me to the next class of deadly fast attack torpedo and missile boat, and that is the Mark 13 Pashi class. The Apache class is a copy of the Chinese Mark 13 torpedo boat, torpedo and missile boat. These boats were constructed way back in 2005, 2006, and some of these were delivered to Iran. Iran received four original versions of these Chinese fast attack and missile and torpedo boats and has begun copying or reverse engineering these vessels for their own navy. In the Iranian Navy, they're known as the Pashi class or Peshi class of fast attack torpedo and missile boats and have been in production since 2007. The vessels weigh 17.8 tons and are armed with either two Nasser 1 or Zafar 1 fire and forget anti-ship cruise missiles. And they could also be fitted with two 324mm homing torpedo tubes. So unlike the previous vessel, the Paykaap class, which could only be fitted with two missile launchers or two torpedo launchers, the Pashi or M13 class or Mark 13 class can be fitted with four weapon systems at once, two torpedo tubes and two missile launchers. There's also enough room in the stern for an additional third missile launcher if need be. Now the vessels have a speed of 62 knots or 110 kilometers per hour or 73.9 miles per hour, and they have an effective range of about 3,000 nautical miles. They have a crew of 3 to 6, and only about 10 vessels have been spotted so far. Although in 2021, Iran unveiled that they are still producing these vessels. In February 2021, Iran unveiled another batch of at least 5 to 6 of the Mark 13 Apache class of a fast attack missile and torpedo boat. So the vessel type is still in production as of 2021, and the actual number of vessels that have been completed is at least 15 to 16 vessels since 2007. And these are the most dangerous of the light torpedo and missile boats. These are the missile boats that weigh less than 20 tons. Now, the last two vessels on the list are larger missile boats and are the largest vessels to serve in the Iranian Revolutionary Guards Corps, with the exception of the Shahid Mohammad Nazari and the Makaran, which are two large logistical vessels. But the next two vessels are the largest combat missile boats to serve in the Iranian Navy. And that brings me to number two. The second most deadly class of Iranian missile boat is the Azarakhsh class of medium fast attack catamaran type missile and torpedo boat that was developed between 2000 and 2002. And these are Iranian copies of the Chinese C-14 class of a fast attack catamaran type missile boats that were developed in China in the late 1990s. And they were delivered to Iran in the year 2000. And Iran has been making copies of these vessels since 2002. Now, these vessels have a displacement of between 19 and 21 tons. The main armament is one 23mm autocannon. It is also fitted with four C-701 and C-704 Nasser anti-ship cruise missile launchers. It also can be fitted with two 324mm torpedo tubes, and can also be fitted with one or two 107mm multiple rocket launching systems. So this vessel here is basically like the Mark 13 Pashi on steroids, so it could carry six missile and torpedo launchers, plus it has enough room for a 23mm bow-mounted machine gun or autocannon. It can also be fitted with one or two additional 107mm multiple rocket launching systems. So these are Katusha rockets, but these are laser-guided Katusha rockets mounted on the top of the vessel. The vessel has a speed of 50 knots or 93 kilometers per hour or 57.7 miles per hour, and it has a crew of 10. Now, only about 10 to 15 of these Azarakhsh class vessels have been produced since 2002, and they are the second largest missile boat to be used by the Iranian Navy. They have enough firepower to tangle with at least an American frigate or maybe a light destroyer, but I don't know if they could go up against the larger destroyers or frigates used by the U.S. Navy, and especially not an aircraft carrier. Keep in mind that these torpedo boats and missile boats are designed to operate together. You know, these boats are not operating independently, They're operating in packs of 10 to 20 vessels at a time. So if you had all 10 of these vessels or all 15 of these vessels attacking at once, they could do some damage, but keep in mind that most of these torpedo and missile boats are lightly armored or have no armor at all. So they are pretty vulnerable to American and even Saudi anti-ship missile systems or anti-torpedo boat and missile boat defense systems that could be fitted to those American vessels. So yes, they are a good offensive weapon, but defensive-wise, they are pretty vulnerable to most modern anti-ship missile systems. And these vessels here are the second largest vessel on the list. And that brings me to the largest class of Iranian missile and torpedo boat that is currently in use with the Iranian Revolutionary Guards Navy, and that is the Tandar class, also known in China as the Haodan class, of large fast attack and torpedo and missile boats that were developed between 1991 and 1994. Now, these vessels were actually constructed in China before Iran was hit with even more sanctions in the mid to late 1990s. Only 10 of these vessels were completed, and these vessels have a displacement of 208 tons. Their main armament are two AK-230 autocannons. These are fully automatic autocannons. These are 30mm autocannons, or anti-aircraft and anti-ship autocannons. They're also fitted with two 23mm light autocannons, and they are fitted with two twin-barreled Ghader-type anti-ship cruise missiles. Now, these are the longest-range anti-ship cruise missiles, are medium-range sea-skimming anti-ship cruise missiles that were developed in the early to mid-2000s. They have a maximum targeting range of 300 kilometers or 186 miles, and they have a speed of about 700 miles per hour. So these missiles are like high-speed Tomahawk cruise missiles, really. The Tomahawk cruise missile can move at 500 miles per hour, so the Ghader missile can move at about 200 miles per hour faster than the average Tomahawk cruise missile. These are anti-ship missiles that were specifically designed to take out American frigates and other light patrol vessels. I don't know if they could tangle with an American destroyer. The speed of these vessels were 35 knots, or about 40 miles per hour, and they have a crew of at least 28 to 30 sailors. And the Tandar class is the largest class of missile boat to be used by the Iranian Revolutionary Guards Crop Navy, and is also the most dangerous vessel on the list. But the Tandar class is the largest and most dangerous warship. Luckily, Iran has only managed to build just 10 of these vessels. But like I said, these are just missile boats, missile and torpedo boats. Yeah, they're good for attacking smaller craft like frigates and patrol vessels, but I don't know if they could ever do any real damage to an American destroyer. These missile and torpedo boats are designed to swarm enemy convoys and enemy carrier task force that are operating off the coast of Iran or in the Persian Gulf or the Strait of Oman. But again, these vessels are mostly older designs. These are all the pre-2010 vessels. So I don't know how good they would be in combat with more modern American destroyers or frigates. But yes, these were the most dangerous and most advanced of the current generation of Iranian missile and torpedo boats. In 2021, Iran unveiled several new types of missile boats, but these boats have not been named yet, and nor have they been tested. So I don't know what these vessels are called yet, but when I do figure out what they are called and their specifications, I will make a video on the more modern or the newest versions of the Iranian missile and torpedo boats. But what do you think of these vessels? Which one were your favorite? Please tell me in the comment section below. And until next time, this was J-Man Time, signing off.